World Health Organization says public health officials are operating in, quote, uncharted territory as they tackle the spread of coronavirus. At last check, more than 90,000 people have been infected in 73 countries and territories. Understandably, that's got a lot of people concerned, Hoosiers included. So we asked you what questions you have about coronavirus on Facebook. And joining me now to answer some of those questions is Dr. Douglas Webb, the medical director of infection control at IU Health. I know you're getting lobbed with questions after question here, so thanks for coming here to address this for us. We're going to start with a question who came from Melanie. She wants to know specifically, she said, what makes this virus more dangerous than the influenza virus that has killed thousands across the United States? So we know how dangerous that is. Coronavirus is new. What do you say to her?
So 2 points. I think we can't lose our focus on influenza because it continues to be rampant throughout this country. We still are seeing lots of cases of severe flu. People are hospitalized. People are put on ventilators in the ICU. It's a terrible disease if you get it. We have a vulnerable population of elderly folks in particular that can get the flu and die. This is very similar. It seems to have, at least from what we know now, a little bit higher mortality rate than the flu, maybe 1 to 2%, although we haven't tested everybody that might have it, so we don't quite know that
yet. Is it more contagious?
Doesn't seem to be any more contagious. They're both spread the same way by respiratory droplets, coughing and sneezing within 3 to 6 feet of the individual. But our fear is that it's a little more higher lethal infection. Yes.
Okay, so that's from Melanie. Dawn wants to know, should I be worried to travel abroad come this spring for trips with my kids' schools? I mean, we're at, a lot of people are, you know, looking at spring break. Should they make alternative plans?
I think you need to keep track of how this disease unfolds in the world. There are certain countries where there seems to be uncontrolled community person-to-person spread. Places like Italy, Iran, South Korea, Japan were added to the State Department's travel list. I would just keep that in mind. Again, use proper precautions as you would with any respiratory virus. I think you just need to look ahead.
If you're going to Florida, if you're going somewhere else.
If you're going to Florida, I would feel free to go to Florida. I would, you know, just look ahead and see how this transpires.
It's the international travel more concerning. Stephanie wants to know, why is the CDC not declaring a pandemic when we have already met the definition of a pandemic with it being in 47 countries? When she asked that, that's where it was, as we said earlier now, it's 73 countries here. Why is it not a pandemic?
I think it's a matter of semantics. There are different definitions for pandemics. It's a new, novel virus. There's person-to-person spread, and there appears to be widespread infection throughout the world. In terms of, you know, how many countries have uncontrolled person-to-person widespread spread, is just a question of how you define it. I think for all intents and purposes, it's widespread infection.
Finally, Willie wants to know, I hear that the biggest concern about the virus is that there are no symptoms in the first 2 weeks. You don't even know you have it, but still can infect people around you. So how do we prevent this from happening when there's no way to even know that we have the virus?
So similar to other respiratory viruses, there may be a period of time from the time you're exposed until you actually develop symptoms where you may not have any symptoms at all. You might be shedding some virus early on. Not everybody develops symptoms that becomes infected, we think. The average time is about 5 days from the time you're exposed until you start developing symptoms. So most of the time you're going to be developing symptoms within that 2 week period of time.
We'll get to a time where we'll be saying, remember when coronavirus was a big deal. We're looking forward to that day. Hopefully we'll get to the other side of that sooner than later. Doctor, thank you. Don't forget to watch our coronavirus fact from fiction special. It's tonight. You'll have even more information to take part in here. We're clearing up some of the misconceptions, showing you how the state is working to protect you. 7 o'clock right here on Fox 59. Thank you for that early preview, Doctor. Appreciate it. All right, 827 and